Good morning. Today we'll be doing the Liturgy of the Hours morning prayer for September 7th. Today is the Saturday of the 22nd week in Ordinary Time. Let's have our moment of silence to prepare us for a prayer. God, come to my assistance.
Lord, make haste to help me.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Hallelujah.
As morning breaks, we sing of your mercy, Lord, and night will find us proclaiming your fidelity.
It is good to give thanks to the Lord, to make music to your name, O Most High, to proclaim your love in the morning and your truth in the watches of the night, of the ten-stringed lyre and the lute, with the murmuring sound of the harp.
Your deeds, O Lord, have made me glad. For the work of your hands I shout with joy. O Lord, how great are your works, how deep are your designs. The foolish man cannot know this, and the fool cannot understand. Though the wicked spring up like grass, and all who do evil thrive, they are doomed to be eternally destroyed. But you, Lord, are eternally on high. See how your enemies perish. All doers of evil are scattered. To me you give the wild ox strength. You anoint me with the purest oil. My eyes look in triumph on my foes. My ears heard gladly on their fall. The just will flourish like a palm tree and grow like a Lebanon cedar. Planted in the house of the Lord, they will flourish in the courts of our God. Still bearing fruits when they are old, still full of sap, still green, to proclaim that the Lord is just, in him, my rock, there is no wrong. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit,
as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
As the morning breaks, we sing your mercies, Lord, and night will find us proclaiming your fidelity. Extol the greatness of our God.
Give ears, O heaven,
while I speak.
Let the earth hearken to the words of my mouth. May my instructions soak like the rain, and my discourse permeate like the dew, like a downpour upon the grass, like a shower upon the crops.
For I will sing the Lord's renown, proclaim the greatness of our God. The rock, how faultless are his deeds, how right all his ways, a faithful God without deceit, how just and upright he is.
Yet basely has it been treated by his degenerate children,
a perverse and a crooked race. Is the Lord to be thus repaid by you, O stupid and foolish people? Is he not your Father who created you? Has he not made you establish you? Think back on the days of old. Reflect on the years of age upon age. Ask your Father, and he will inform you. Ask your elders, and they will tell you.
When the Most High assigned the nations their heritage, when he parceled out the descendants of Adam, he set up the boundaries of the peoples after the number of the sons of God, while the Lord's own portion was Jacob, his hereditary share was Israel.
He found them in a wilderness, a wasteland of howling desert. He sheltered them and cared for them, guarding them as the apple of his eyes.
As an eagle inside its nestling fort,
by hovering over its brood,
so he spread his wings to receive them and bore them up in his pinions.
The Lord alone was their leader. No strange God was with him.
Glory to the Father,
and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit,
as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
Amen. Extol the greatness of our God. How wonderful is your name, O Lord, in all creation.
How great is your name, O Lord, our God, through all the earth.
Your majesty is raised above the heavens, on the lips of children and of babes. You have found praise to fall your enemy, to silence the foe and the rebel. When I see the heavens, the work of your hands, the moon and the stars which you arrange, what is man that you should keep him in mind, mortal man that you care for him? Yet you have made him little less than a God. With glory and honor you crowned him, gave him power over the works of your hands, put all things under his feet. All of them, sheep and cattle, yes, even the savage beasts, birds of the air and fish, that make their ways through the waters. How great is your name, O Lord our God, through all the earth. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. How wonderful is your name, O Lord, in all creation.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Bless your persecutors. Bless and do not curse them. Rejoice with those who rejoice. Weep with those who weep. Have the same attitude toward all. Put away ambitious thoughts and associate with those who are lowly. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Good morning, my dear friends. Most of us in America have not experienced anything comparable to the persecution that our brothers and sisters in other countries are facing. In Algeria, we read and see slaughtering of Christians and destroying churches. In many other countries, numerous Christians have been imprisoned, killed, or forced to leave their homes and flee for their life. But in addition to persecution, Paul this morning jumps to two other topics, sympathy and humility, that seem unrelated. Rejoice with those who rejoice, and weep with those who weep. Be of the same mind toward one another. Do not be haughty in mind, but associate with the lowly. Do not be wise in your own estimation. Are these just random thoughts that Paul throws out without any connection with each other? Perhaps, but there do seem to be some connecting factors. For one thing, each of these commands reflects transformed attitudes. Back in chapter 12, Paul said, "And do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, so that you may prove what the will of God is, that which is good and acceptable and perfect." Now, he's showing what this transformed, renewed mind looks like. It blesses enemies who have persecuted them. It sympathizes with others in their joys and sorrows, and it demonstrates genuine humility.
It is my joy, O God, to praise you with song.
It is my joy, O God, to praise you with song.
To sing as I ponder your goodness.
To praise you with song.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
It is my joy, O God, to praise you with song.
Lord, guide our feet into the way of peace.
Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel. He has come to his people and set them free.
He has raised up for us a mighty Savior, born of the house of his servant David.
Through his holy prophets, he promised of old that he would save us from our enemies, from the hands of all who hate us.
He promised to show mercy to our fathers and to remember his holy covenant.
This was his oath he swore to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies, free to worship him without fear, holy and righteous in his sight all the days of our life.
You, my child, shall be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare his way, to give his people knowledge of salvation by the forgiveness of their sins.
In the tender compassion of our God, the dawn from on high shall break upon us to shine on those who dwell in darkness and the shadows of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit,
as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Lord, guide our feet into the way of peace. Let us celebrate the kindness and wisdom of Christ. He offers his love and understanding to all men, especially to the suffering. Let us earnestly pray to him.
Perfect us in love, Lord.
This morning we recall your resurrection.
And we long for the benefits of your redemption.
Grant that we bear witness to you today, Lord.
And all for an acceptable gift to the Father through you.
Enable us to see your image in all men.
And to serve you in them.
Lord Jesus, you are the true vine and we are the branches.
Allow us to remain in you, to bear much fruit, and to give glory to the Father.
Let us pause for a moment to lift up our prayers and petitions to our Lord Jesus Christ. Dear Lord Jesus, we lift up to you our prayers and our petitions, together with the prayers and petitions of each and everyone who are praying with us this morning. We ask, dear Jesus, that you hear and answer each and every prayer as we pray.
Perfect us in love, Lord. Gathering our prayers and praises into one, we now pray the prayer Jesus taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done,
on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Let us pray. Lord, we praise you with our lips and with our lives and hearts. Our very existence is a gift from you. To you we offer all that we have and are. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you for praying with us.
We hope you can join us again tomorrow.
Same time,
same place,
same channel. Have a great day.